think we have an excellent group here at the University of Maryland that deal with hand and upper extremity. We cover the entire gamut of the spectrum of pathology that you can see. So from the extreme crush injuries and the extreme fractures with multiple limb involvement to the simple tendinopathies and the simple common aches and pains you have in your upper extremity. We have everyone that can take care of it. Probably the number one diagnosis we see is carpal tunnel syndrome. The most common complaint is numbness and tingling in the fingers. Most commonly the thumb, the index finger, the middle finger, and the ring finger. A lot of patients will classically complain of nighttime numbness and tingling that causes them to wake up and shake their hands. They would also complain of symptoms associated with specific activities that cause flexion or extension of their wrists. So driving for long periods, doing their hair in the morning. A lot of patients would associate it with typing for long periods. Treatment of carpal tunnel syndrome is very well established. There's usually initial non-operative treatments and what do those include. So some element of activity modification. So if there's a specific activity that's bringing on your symptoms, you try to avoid it as much as possible. Then the other conservative measures like nighttime splinting, which involves having the wrist in a neutral position, so no extreme flexion or extension to try to rest the nerve within the carpal tunnel. The other activities, activity modification that the therapist can help with. There are also injections that can be used to help with the symptoms. And finally, if none of those work and your symptoms continue to persist, then surgery is a final option. So surgery for carpal tunnel syndrome is also very well established and has been done for multiple years. It's an outpatient procedure, and what that entails is an incision in the palm of the hand. There are probably two main techniques for doing this. There's a mini technique that's an endoscopic technique, and there's a typical open technique. And what both of those techniques aim to achieve is to release the ligament that's covering the carpal tunnel, taking the pressure off of the nerve, and hopefully the nerve can then repair itself and the patient can be symptom-free. So when the patient walks in the door with a disabling complaint, whether it's from an acute trauma, whether it's from a nerve pain, or for whatever reason they have an inability to use the extremity, and you're able to do whatever the procedure is, whether it's a fracture fixation or a tendon transfer or a nerve repair, and they come back and they have excellent function and they've come around 180 degrees from where they started, that's what drives me to come to work and do what I do every day.